Slop City Podcast!
Oh, that's beautiful! Oh!
I feel like making love. Is my camera on? Is my camera on? Is my camera on? Okay, I'm starting to believe that I have deformed ear holes. Sometimes I'll take...
What?
Sometimes I'll just take both little paws, both little pinkies, and just put them in there just to check things out because I've been very concerned about it. And we're getting different ratios.
What concerns you?
They're different sizes, man. You know what I haven't tried, though, is putting these fingers in these ears. I haven't tried that, so maybe it's the size of my pinky. Because to me, they look the same.
Well, they say, the doctors say that no two things on the human body are the same size. Your eyes, your nose holes, your butthole, pussy.
Tell that to Kim Kardashian.
Huh. I don't... really have any way to contact her, so I'm not...
Yeah, you're not going to be able to do that.
Sure how
it was just a tongue-in-cheek thing, man. Golly.
Your tongue is in your...
My tongue's in my cheek.
Is that when you tell a joke and you go...
No, that you usually do that for... you usually do that for a blowjob. Oh, God, I love it. It's such a fucking roast. Randy, if you did something real fucking stupid... And someone was like looking at you to roast you and they hit you with a, you're mad, right? Like, why'd you roast me with that? I'm mad. I see someone doing that.
I would think come up with something a little better.
For sure. See, I would actually be like, God, the fact that you went so simple makes me angry. That's how I felt the first time it happened to me.
I don't know if I've ever had that happen to me.
Yeah, it's not a good feeling. Well, we are back in the Slop Dojo, everybody.
What's dojo mean?
I don't know. It's like a cool word. Sounds like dungeon, but kind of like jungle, kind of like Michael. I'm thinking Michael Jordan. I'm thinking dojo, the Krav Maga. To me, it screams cool.
I feel like the sentence, though, should have been like, we're back in the Slop City, and then it should have been a noun. But I feel like dojo is more of an adjective.
Randy's going to go ahead and shake his head no on that. And he is really, and I know you were a teacher. I'm not trying to tell you who or what you can be or, you know, any of that.
Uh-oh, Randy's over there just looking intently at knobs.
Do you know what I'm so fucking excited to use today? Recording what? In Randy's place. Number one, I'm just excited to be sitting. Yeah.
Me too.
A bathroom. Don't have to use Libby's piss bucket in the storage. area.
Got a problem with my piss bucket?
I do not at all. I just still cannot believe that the following morning after you were hey, don't let me forget my piss bucket.
I had to use it at home for a couple days.
Oh, when there was a storm that blew by?
Well, I moved downstairs and
oh, you're all moved in.
I'm all moved in.
Okay,
and,
we'll get to that.
Had some plumbing issues. Okay. And I think I may have found the issue. I'll get into that later.
Oh, God. I'm so scared. I heard about this from Greg and everyone.
Lift that mic up.
Is that good? Okay, so I wasn't talking.
You heard about
right
what
decision.
I'm about to tell you from Greg?
I have not. No, I haven't heard about any of it. What I heard about is, and listen, I just want you to know, I did make some notes for today. At the top, it says chicken al pastor burrito bowl, but... Under that, I just was like, I want to touch on some points because we haven't done an episode for 2 weeks. I know everyone's feeling weird about it. People are like, are you okay?
Are you guys in Slop City?
Oh, I've gotten that. I've gotten, Tina, are you okay? Something's wrong. We haven't heard from you. And I'm like, bro, I'm literally just trying to adjust to life back again.
On
even though I've been home.
St. Louis.
Back on the streets of St. Louis. Yeah, 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 yeah. We got to get Randy to get that song on here, man.
If he gets the Rodecaster Pro, he can get it.
Oh, you can only have that song? Do you think I could buy that from
I'm sure.
online?
I'm sure.
Rodecaster Pro, driving through the streets of Chicago theme song. What was the first city we did the driving of the, down the streets to?
Austin?
Yeah. No, I don't think it was Austin.
Chicago?
Maybe it was the Boston Globetrotters. Randy, yeah. Did you watch any of the episodes that we did while we were on the road?
All of them but that one.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yep,
that was every one of them.
Honestly, I don't blame you. I can't. It's very difficult to watch my friend's podcast.
We were lucky to be alive at that point.
Yeah. Oh, God.
I've been kind of busy. Like, I started a new job and shit, and yeah, I've been busy.
Wow. Cool. Hey, no judgment.
Good, thank you.
No, judging.
No, there really is no judgment. But I just knew the answer would be no. So it's like, LOL. Oh, got a text message. Want to make sure that it is not our Chipotle driver. Ooh, our order is going to be delivered at 7:10 p.m. That's going to be in about 20 minutes.
Oh, we'll be ready.
We placed an order for Chipotle. Randy's never had it, so we're going to try that today. Knock that off my list. Gonna cross off chicken.
El Pastor.
El Pastor burrito bowl. That is off the list. But yeah, I just wanted to make sure, you know, we talk about some fun stuff and all that. Because we haven't done it in a while. Everything's fine. I'm okay. Just adjusting to life as a human back at home. Bo was very sick when I got home. He is not sick anymore. He's all good. Simba has been having the craziest diarrhea ever for a week solid now. So it's just like, that's why.
Everyone's adjusting. Whoa, that's got super loud.
Yeah.
Did I get louder?
Not to me. Felt just pretty normal.
That sounds tingy and tangy. There we go.
Well, I think he had a hard J in the word adjusting.
Adjusting.
Kind of like adjective, which he tried to sizzle me on.
Like an adjunct professor.
Dude, I was literally listening to the radio the other day because I'm my boyfriend from works on the radio show the other day. I do not listen to it every morning, and I'm not saying that to be like a cool guy who's like Randy, you know, who's like, yeah, I watched every single one but that one. I'm not trying to be like that,
right?
But I do watch it. But either way, someone was talking on there who's a musician. This guy, Moon, that was in Story of the Year and stuff, he was like, kept saying the word adjacent. And someone didn't know that it was like a music festival. They were like, what was it next to? And it was like, it was a quick comment. But at
the festival is called Adjacent?
I guess it's a big music festival, Adjacent. But just a lot of ADJ words in the last few minutes. And in the last week that have really spoke out to me.
You know what that means? It means you're on the right path.
I've been having a lot of God moments.
Well,
and that means do you think I'm on the right path? Do you think there are going to be footsteps that I will see beside me when I go on my annual Don Sirloin trip to Fort Walton Beach, Florida?
No, it'll be one thing of footprints, and then you'll curse at the Lord, and you'll say, whoa, why weren't you there? And he'll say, I was carrying you, idiot. Those are my footprints.
And then I'm going to get airlifted into a helicopter out of the ocean, and it's going to be my turn to get what that lady got when she was like, whoa.
Super dizzy. That's what she got.
She got super dizzy, almost dead.
What is that word?
Disoriented.
What is it when your ears are off balance?
Tinnitus. Vertigo.
Yes.
Vertigo.
God.
I don't know if you would ever be the same after something like that, bro.
Oh, hell no.
I mean, you'd probably walk into a room, see a fan, and be like... You can't see a fan ever again.
Just start punching.
You just be like, anytime you see one. But yeah, moral of the story is everything's fine. Just adjusting to life as a human. I am assuming that's kind of what Libby's been doing.
Yeah, and moving.
You know, yeah. So give us your move update.
Everything is down there. I ordered a new desk because I need a bigger desk. The desk,
for that fat ass.
For the fat ass. The desk I bought, I'm using as my TV, and now Annie uses that to catapult herself up into the ductwork.
Are you fucking kidding me?
No.
So I got fucking Pissy McGee at my house, Shitty McGee / Vomit Some Days McGee at my house, and you got Catapult Nanny. You got Amelia Earhart up in your motherfucking house.
She is a lizard serial killer. What? She's been killing lizards. It's going out of style.
Did not even know there was lizards in Nashville.
Didn't know there was lizards in the basement.
What the fuck? Yeah, well, that's a big shock to me, but I'm more surprised. I was like, maybe one got transported in one of your luggage, you know? Like, Beth was doing this weird thing where she's like, oh, well, I did not transport a lizard, but it's like, we all know she transported a lizard.
Yeah, I didn't know there were lizards there either, but I had to do a lot of research because every time she'd bring it...
And does she bring it to you?
She brings it in there by me and starts playing with it. And the tail is already gone. The tail's gone. And the tail is writhing on the ground by itself.
Wait, moving?
Which you're
like,
I wanted
is that an earthworm after a big rain? And you're like, what the fuck? It's a tail.
I scream because it's scary to see a dismembered tail. Just
oh, yeah.
But I guess... If a lizard is being captured by its tail, they can just be like, drop it off. Because they'll grow a new one.
Oh, sure. So
there's lizard tails everywhere.
Oh, my God.
Every time I turn around, there's a new lizard tail. And today, she had another lizard. It was in the bathroom. And I thought, oh, God, it's dead. I'll get it after my shower. I get out and she starts toying with it. And it runs. It wasn't even dead. It was just like.
The lizard ran?
Yes.
Without its tail?
Yeah, it runs around without its tail.
So that she has a method as a serial killer. She is going for the tail first. That's what we need to be looking for here. I mean, if you ever, you know, that's what they do when they're trying to figure out what's wrong with the serial killer. They're like, okay, so what's he doing? How can we identify these crimes?
That's her MO. There's two tails laying on the ground.
What the fuck? Those are huge. Those look like, give me that.
They look like little alligators.
Randy, I'll send that to you. Will you mark this time? I mean, I know you did, but like, we'll just, holy fuck. That's the size of, that's longer than Simba's tail.
Well, I mean, it's like that big. Oh. It just looks big.
Oh, okay.
It's terrifying. So every day she kills lizards. So that's cool. She's having a great time doing it too, because she'll just be like, puts it on the floor and it'll run off underneath something. And she'll just like relax and then go back over there and just be like,
how the fuck did she even find these lizards? Because
she's a hunter.
Free reign.
She's a hunter.
Hunter gatherer, fun time guy. We need to get Annie a little Cabela credit card. Get her a Cabela's credit card. Really show her who's boss.
Get her a little safari hat and jacket.
Oh, yeah.
I got a nice one here.
Oh, crikey. It's like, Annie, stop, dude. You're not Australian.
She doesn't eat them. She just toys with them until their eventual death. And then I take a little piece of toilet paper and put them in the trash can.
You take a little bite off the lizard's tail. You take a little nibble.
I wait to see how long it takes to grow back, and then I bite it off.
I can't fucking believe that. But I will say, dude, like, in that picture, it definitely looks like that tail is very long. I mean, we're talking 2 feet. I would say that photo, the way that you took it, it
that
looks
long.
Massive.
That long.
What? I did not know that there was lizards in Tennessee. It makes sense, I guess, because when you go to, like... Castlewood or whatever.
Disgusting.
You know, whatever fun places.
They look like little crocodiles.
Oh, God.
Because at first I'm like, what is she doing? And I look down and see the little lizard running and the little tail moving. And I was like, ah!
Oh, God. So give me the layout because, okay, Libby moved from upstairs to downstairs. A lot of people traded houses. There's a whole shift going on in the Frank's
community.
You know that, yeah, that whole community in Tennessee. So y'all, you moved down.
I moved downstairs.
My sound stopped. I don't know why.
I can still hear you.
Okay, I can't hear.
You were messing myself with your headphone card.
Was I? Is that what it is?
Maybe
let me try
it
again.
In harder.
Oh yeah. Oh yeah, Daddy. Oh yeah. Oh, hold on. Sorry. Oh yeah. Oh, there it is.
My dad came into town, meaning my sister, came into town to help me. Well, she didn't come in to help me, but she was there, so she helped me move stuff. Beth moved my giant dresser downstairs by herself.
Really? What a psycho. Your dresser, the one that's really tall, or the one that
yeah,
was...
Yeah, and heavy as fuck.
She
like
moved
solid
that by
wood.
Herself?
Yeah, because I go, all I need is the dresser moved, and she comes back upstairs. She goes, okay, I got it down there. And I go, what? I go, what did you... Your dresser? I go, huh? And I got up and went in and looked, because I was like, she's tricking me.
What? Why would she trick you?
Because
you're like,
I could
you're
not
like,
believe
no
it.
Way that
yeah,
she did
I couldn't
it herself.
Believe it.
You thought she was like doing a bit or something.
Yeah.
Okay.
My sister moved my mattress down there by herself.
And by that, you mean she just opened the door and was like.
That's what I've been doing to everything.
Oh,
anything that doesn't break, I've been throwing it down there.
I've done that with moves. We're talking pillows, whatever, anything. Anything that's not going to break.
Down the steps.
Down the steps, brother. Especially at that house I lived in Dogtown way back when that had like 56 steps.
The one that had pictures of Simba inside of it?
Not that one. God, that was God, that was a nice one. Randy, I think it's got to be some kind of connection thing over here.
Don't buy your headphones at Walgreens.
Because these were a little funky. Okay, I guess I can, hold on. Hello? Hello?
Hello?
Hello? Okay. Yeah, that's fine. I guess. It does sound funky to me, but we can deal with that later. Sorry, one sec.
Okay.
Okay. okay.
Okay. I'll be here when you're ready.
Looks like
I'll just keep talking about my room since you're...
Yeah.
Everything's down there except my desk that I ordered from Wayfair, and they didn't have the kids ready to put inside of the desk to ship it to me, so they had to... It's taking longer than I thought, you know, because Wayfair has kids in their cabinets. Remember
oh,
that
okay.
Whole thing?
I do remember that, but did just get a little spooked. I was like, sorry, what?
I'm sorry.
What is that again?
You're going to do what?
Okay.
And I can't really complete everything till the desk is in there. For some reason, my brain won't let me complete it, but I have a microwave and a fridge and a touchless trash can down there. So pretty much I don't have to leave.
Whoa. So yeah, you're going to be there.
I don't have to go anywhere.
For quite a while.
I mean, until they kick me out.
Now, okay, so you've got, how's that bathroom working out for you?
The bathroom was working out great now. They had to have somebody come by and fix it.
Uh-huh.
And they did. And he goes, oh, that little thing's making a funny noise. Because there's a pump, because they don't have sewage downstairs, so they have to pump it up.
Yeah.
Instead of it going out, they have to pump it up and put it in their sewage. He's like, that pump's about to go out. And
plug it into the one next to it. I mean, I can hear myself good now. I turned it up a little. I think it's okay. Hey, Libby, go fuck yourself. This story sucks, man. We're just.
I haven't even gotten to the good part yet.
I'm joking.
The best part. And those guys leave after everything's working. You know, they had to pay a plumber to come.
Okay.
It was all fucked up. When Greg came home one time, he said there was a mouse in there. Greg is fucking it up, and I don't know what Greg was doing. Anyway, it was fucked up for weeks.
Well, I guess he thought it was tampons or something that was in there. Maybe some debris from someone's asshole was left.
Maybe left. A wipes. I don't know. And then, so those guys leave, and I go in there to flush it, and I hear a big clunkety clunk. And thought that was strange. I walk away and I come back a few minutes later to use the bathroom again. Look in there. And what do I see in there?
Oh, my God.
One of Tina's smoke cartridges in the bottom.
of the toilet?
Yes. And I put my little hand in there. And I was like, huh? And it was all like rusted. You know when a pirate goes to the bottom of the sea and gets stuff and it's all rusted?
No.
That's how it looked.
Oh, my God. I followed you. And did you say, excuse me, no smoking inside?
I should have.
God.
And I told Beth later, earlier, because I had thought it was a marijuana one. I go, everything's working fine, because she was about to have an aneurysm over this bathroom thing because the plumbers weren't doing what they're supposed to be doing. She wanted them to completely just remove the pump, and then we were going to get a new one. And I'm like, it works fine. Everything's fine. I go, but I did find one of your weed pen things in there, you know, the top part. And she's like, oh. She was kind of freaked out. And then I was sitting there and go, you know what? That wasn't a... I go, the weed ones are circular. This one was flat. And I go, wait a minute. And she goes, oh, I'm off the hook. Because she thought she dropped it in there. So I don't know how that got in there or why that was in there. But it's been free and clear ever since. It was a loud ka-conk.
Wait a second. Did that vape cartridge cause...
I don't know.
All of these problems?
No.
There's no way.
There's no
right?
way. Because when Greg came home...
He was like, it's a tampon.
There was something in there that made him...
Call the police. Call the authorities.
Destroy the toilet with whatever he was doing. So I think they just turned off all the water to it until the plumbers came. And then the plumber literally took like 5 minutes to fix it.
He was like, well, after he fixed it, he was like, well, might as well drop one in, see if this puppy's working.
So I
would
don't.
You, would you let a plumber do that if they came
to
over to your house? Well, no, if they fixed it. It's been having recurring problems. There's just a lot going on. And the plumber was dead fucking serious. Like, all right, well, I think I'm going to drop a deuce right now.
Oh, I'd have no problem.
See if this thing doesn't start working or not.
I'd have no problem.
And he says something like, and I got some mean ones. I mean, they are viscous. And he says
I'd be like, okay,
viscous.
Bro.
And you're like, wait, did you say viscous or biscuits?
I'd be like, do you want me to leave the room? Because I don't usually close the bathroom door, so you have to leave it open.
Yeah. So
it's been working. Hopefully it'll keep on working.
So, but what did that plumber say he did? Was he like, yeah, I just
he didn't tell me because I wasn't the homeowner. He just said, it's probably not gonna last much longer. It's making a noise.
And I think
once it released the it's not those.
It's not
no
this?
It is that one. It
yeah.
is that one.
That's
it's,
what it is.
It said golden tobacco on it.
Yep.
And I was
it.
Like, oh my God.
Wow.
Well,
I'm just glad it wasn't my fault. Oh, it was holding on to it with every bit. Just holding on. You think
How
it was
did
just circling
you drop
around?
That in there? That's what I wanted to know.
Who knows, dude? Could have been
you
willy-nilly.
Like, not even knowing that the thing is falling in there.
What do you think I said before? Or did
I think you were just in there probably shitting and you're smoking, looking at your phone and maybe wiped with the thing in your hand still, and then it fell down, and then later you were like, where's the top of my vape pen?
Oh, no, I don't wipe while I'm holding
I
it.
Oh, why?
No,
I don't wipe.
Oh, no, I don't wipe.
I don't wipe.
Nope, I do not. Dude, here's something I gotta say. I'm starting to be out on bidets. I don't want to see bidets in people's bathrooms anymore. I'm over it. I'm fucking grossed out. I've had enough. If I walk into your bathroom and you're like, yeah, that's the public bathroom, and there's a bidet in there, and there is any fucking poop on there, I'm losing it.
Is that because of Chelsea's poop?
Everyone's, dude. I've been in so many people's houses recently, and it's like, it's not their fault. It's just too much to keep up with. There's things splashing. There's all this turmoil.
Right.
In a toilet during the bidet action.
Right.
And, I mean, you know, I had that flu diarrhea for fucking days. Just piss and water. I mean, just literally.
I think that the people that don't invest in good ones that retract... It's the cheap ones that just stay right there.
Yeah. Okay.
Maggie used to have one that was very nice and had hot water, but when it was done, it would retract and not be visible.
Yeah. I just, I don't like it. And it's like, I'm not knocking anybody for having a dirty toilet. It does happen. And I think why it happens to a lot of people is that people don't realize how long, people don't realize how much you need to keep up with your toilet, especially if you know you're a shitter, dude. Gotta keep up with the toilet.
Not just a shitter, but somebody that's blasting.
If you know you're a blaster, by my age right now, it's like I know what kind of shitter I am, and I can pretty much predict with accuracy what kind of shit I'm going to be having based on the feeling in my stomach, what the vibe is, you know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. The more that I feel like I can really hold on to that guy, that means I'm about to have a healthy poo. Okay. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, yeah.
When I feel out of control, when it's like that song, like, I've got one hand in my pocket, you know, that Alanis mm-hmm. Morissette, whatever kind of cool Alanis Morissette song comes on where I'm scared and kind of like, it wasn't that one. What's the other song where it's like, rain on your wedding day. So that one, I feel like that one is kind of what I'm talking about right here. But when I'm, you know, I know what's going on. I know what kind of shit I'm going to have. And I know that I'm not the biggest blaster in the world. Rafe, what do you think he shits like?
Blast.
Blast. Blasting.
But does he blast onto the backboard like Chelsea?
Honestly. I went to this home run derby last night, and there was a ball that I swear to God was about to hit me in the head. And the ones that were almost home runs would slam into the scoreboard right next to me. And that's what I am thinking of, just blast in the backer. That sound, I couldn't imagine.
It's got to be a ricochet, too, when it's that high.
Yeah.
You know you're getting some poo-poo back on you.
There is shit on the top of our toilet seat, you know.
And that's fine.
Yeah, I'm not mad about it. But I'm saying you really do need to keep up with your toilet. Because Rafe lifts the toilet when he pees, mm-hmm. you know, whatever. Which, to be honest, at this point, I'm like, you know, you're 40. You should know how to pee. You don't need to lift that toilet seat anymore. You know what I mean? Just keep it down. Keep it down.
Well, as a 40-year-old, it's worse, though, because their ding-dongs don't spray as well. Wow. So that's even... Wouldn't you say that? I don't have a ding-dong, but...
Yeah, are you losing some ding-dong speed?
Drip.
You dripping. Tend to drip.
They need their pelvic floors tightened up.
So wait a second. You're dripping a lot more now than you did 20 years ago?
Oh, hell yeah, dude. That shit is like, okay, before it... But like it would be like a brand new faucet when you turn the water on, it goes, come out like a fire hose. Now that's just like an old trickly bathroom faucet, dude. Sometimes it takes a minute, dude. Here's a funny thing: I haven't shared this publicly. After I poop and wipe my butt when I stand up, now I have to pee again.
Really?
Yeah, I don't know why that is, dude.
Because you're stimulating your prostate. Your prostate's
I'm just touching the outside, dude. I'm not like getting up in there and shit.
Yeah, Randy's prostate's like this.
I haven't shared this publicly.
Well,
you heard it here first, folks.
You heard it here first, everybody.
He dribbles what he pees.
He dribbles what he pees. Producer of Slop City Podcast, Randy Cash, dribbler.
Do you dribble when you cub too?
That's kind of personal, but yeah.
Yeah.
Well, that's it's not gotten, publicly boop, traded information boop, yet.
Kind of gotten thicker, too. I don't know.
Maybe
that means, maybe that means I'm no longer fertile, which are would be on, fantastic.
Well, great. We let's should take fuck, because I only want to fuck non-fertile got people.
Let's look at your jizz under a microscope and see if we see any swimmers.
I would love... Is that how they tell? Is that all they do? They're just like, all right, we're going to be... I mean, I think that should be a pretty quick process. I'm just sick of all these places taken for fucking ever. All this fucking turnaround on medical things, medical stuff like that. Everything's on whatever fucking Epic records or whatever fucking bullshit you nurses use. And yeah, I just made a joke inside baseball about places. Yeah. But I'm just saying, like, why do things take long? Why do you need to analyze things? No, I want it quick.
Well, you're
get my cum, get your microphone. Take a piece, put it in between, get your microphone, do a type 5 for your patient.
Why don't you have them come in your mouth and just go like this? and see if you can feel little tiny sperms.
Yeah.
Can you see sperm swimming under
Let's watch a couple of videos. I want to see.
Other people have.
Oh, my God. Randy looking this up for me right now is making me so happy. I would be happy to look it up. But just having this screen up is so nice.
Mm.
Feels good.
What kind of microscope is required to evaluate sperm motility?
So here's the deal. If you're doing any kind of semen sightseeing,
right.
You're doing any of that, you are not going to be able to use a standard microscope. Okay, what we're going to be looking at here at a microscope center.
Right.
Head on over this way, microscope center. Okay. What we're going to be looking at, and I am not a doctor. This is just a lab coat, standard lab coat. This is like a, you know, Harbor Freight tools, yeah. Except Harbor Medical tools, if you know what I'm saying. Fun stuff.
You're funny, sir.
No problem. You're not going to be able to use a standard microscope. You are going to need to get yourself a sub-Saharan standard microscope.
Well, Miss Jenkins, at school, we have little microscopes that we use during science hour.
May I ask you something, little kid?
Yeah.
What are you doing up here at this microscope center all by your lonesome? How old are you, son?
8. My mom is downstairs. My dad had to get some new, what are those little glass things you put under the microscope to look at samples?
It's a Bunsen slide.
Yeah, he had to get some more. My dad's a love.
It's a slide. What is it? What is it, kid? Help me. What Miss
Jenkins
say? I
don't know. I'm asking you. You're the guy that works at Microsoft Center.
Microscope Center. God, people always want to call us Micro Center, and I just get sick of it, you know? Calling up here all the time. Hey, do you have the Dell? And I'm like, no. You know what I've got is help to power the guy that runs the Dell, that writes the code. That's what I've got here is medical equipment jokes.
What?
Here. So, what was your name again, kid?
Gary.
Gary. So, you're just kind of here chit-chatting around.
Just was checking stuff out. I came up here and I thought you were a doctor, so I was going to ask you some medical questions.
Oh, you can ask me some medical questions. I do. I am legally obliged, though, to tell you that there is no way in heckaroni that you can sue me if so, you know. Yeah, you're not worried about that. You're a young kid.
I don't know how to sue.
Hey, hit me.
Well,
I can help you out.
The reason my dad wants more slides is because every time he makes love to my mommy, he wants to make a baby, and there's no babies.
Okay.
So he wants to put my mommy's discharge and his discharge in a slide together to see if they make a embryo.
You know, some people would be appalled to hear a child your age saying stuff like that. But you know what I say? I say it's a way of the future. These children need to know. They need to know what's going on. Because, I mean, pretty soon, these are just things we all need to be talking about. I love that you're also saying terms like making love and stuff like that instead of the usual disgusting terms I hear cats coming in here saying things like, I don't know if you've ever heard this one. Let me whisper it in your ear. Fucking.
I've heard that before.
People love saying that one. These guys that come in here, they love saying that one. They say, hey, where's that slide and the little piece of acid looking square, you know, that you could almost put it inside your, do you know what acid is, kid?
Yeah, it's inside batteries.
Exactly. You get what I'm saying.
Hey, mister, your phone keeps going off.
Oh, no, it's just I have so many notifications on it that at this point I feel so lost I can't even begin to go through every application and turn off every notification. But,
Hey, mister, can I ask you a question?
Yeah, no problem, pal.
You think maybe...
Need a water? I got Dasani, Aquafina,
I don't
and like a
Dasani.
Spring water.
You think maybe you could help my mommy and daddy make a baby? Because my mommy said if my daddy doesn't make a baby, she's going to leave him.
I just farted.
You farted? Mister.
Sorry, kids. Sometimes when somebody poses me with a big question like that, something sort of a quest.
Whoa.
Sorry, bud. When somebody poses me with a quest, adventure, a question.
Yeah?
That's going to be hard to... answer, solve, tell, do. I get a little, GI stuff going on. Not the GI Bill. I'll tell you that. No, it's not that. I never had that. They didn't give it to me. What? I got it stolen from me.
I know I shouldn't ask you that. You're a stranger, mister.
Hey, listen, kid. I'll do anything I can to help you, but here's the deal. Your mother like pineapple.
Yeah.
Cue 70s disgusting like sex music. And then the guy pretending to be a doctor. They just have a screenshot of his face like this. He's just there to make cool sex jokes at the end.
Oh my.
What a cool guy. That was a nice little cool thing.
I would love to go to Microscope Center.
Oh God. Imagine all the things you're gonna see. Yeah.
Oh, probably a lot of stuff under microscopes. Maybe a mold or a fungi. Maybe you could take one of your pubic hairs and put it in between two slides and see how it looks.
I'd be okay with implementing a microscope policy into my life. You know what I'm saying? Microscope policy. Microscope.
Okay.
Good God, I'm dumb today.
Like what?
Which sucks because it was a cool sentence. If I hit that hard, like how I thought it was going to be. The first time you said what, I blacked out because I was like, that's such a funny thought. I can't believe that you just said what. And then I realized I said microscope.
You think we should get a microscope here at the Slop City headquarters?
Would you? I got a question for you and I already know my answer. Would you be willing to
stick my fingers in your ear holes to feel if they're the same size?
No, they definitely are not. And there's too much psoriasis in there. Going to the dermatologist on Tuesday. I am ready to start getting shots because I don't want to deal with this anymore.
Oh,
I'm going to let them just shoot me up. I'm done. I'm over it. But what I'm asking you, and like I said, I know my answer. My answer is going to be a yes. I'm asking you, would you be willing to, if we do get a Slop City microscope, take one of those two fingers or whatever you want, dunk it inside of your pussy hole, put the slide on, see what's going on in there. Because I got an answer for you right now.
Sure.
I'm in.
I would rather do it on something sterile like a Q-tip, though, and then use the one of those long Q-tips.
I think you're actually right.
And then put it on the slide. Because I could, if I had something on my hands, that would also show up on the slide.
I will say, though, here's the thing that I think would be hysterical is to make sure to have the whole setup just like normal, But, I also could sit here and take a Q-tip and just put it inside of me. And I want you guys to know my pussy's deep, okay? It's deep.
Oh, wow.
Just kidding. It's not. My cervix hangs very low.
Oh.
So I could just probably use a regular Q-tip, put it all the way in there.
Are you going to put it all the way in or just at the tip?
Oh, I'm fine with doing a full swab.
Okay.
I mean, I'm fine with that. I'm fine with putting the Q-tip in and then doing a full swab. And then I think you're right. It does need to be sterile, though, because there could be some germs that are on here.
It's cross-contamination. That's what I was thinking of. Sure. I'd probably go in the bathroom, do a quick swipe, then put it on the slide and put the other slide on top. I wouldn't do it out here.
You wouldn't.
Sounds like you're wanting to do it out here.
Yeah, I was actually thinking to do it out here. I could actually, here's what I could do. I used to do T9, back when we had Nokia phones. I knew the T9s by heart. So I could like look down or not look down and I could do it. I'm telling you right here, right now, I could take a big Q-tip and I wouldn't even have to unbutton these shorts I'm wearing right now. And it would have to be this pair of shorts because they're the right kind of looseness and all that. Mm. Take a big Q-tip, slide it in, get it inside my pussy hole right here. I guarantee you I could do it without you even noticing.
Do you think that we should do it like when you give a urine sample where you have to wipe with a little alcohol pad?
Oh, yeah. Your pussy hole or just whatever?
Just the area first. Oh,
sure. I think you should. Maybe the outside just so there's no debris. If there's any leftover saliva
maybe
from
some
your
doo-doo
partner, then yeah, if there's a doo-doo. God. Ugh. I don't want to talk about shit. I don't know how these motherfuckers out here having babies because I'm cleaning up Simba's diarrhea. And I can't even tell you how many times I've thrown up.
Oh, my God.
Just,
what's wrong with it?
An abhorrent amount of times I've vomited.
A what?
Abhorrent.
I have never heard that word. That's
yeah, you
word.
Have. Abhorrent.
Is she doing a bit? Isn't it abhorrent? Or is the H silent?
Oh, I've always said abhorrent. I mean, right here, right now. Dude, I have always said abhorrent. I just have.
Why are you saying words wrong today?
Abhorrent. I don't know. Hey, our Chipotle got delivered, by the way.
Did it?
Yeah.
Oh, I've been looking at the fucking cameras like, where's this motherfucker at? I'm going to. Yeah, okay, good enough.
At least I got a note that said, your order has been delivered. And I swear to fucking God.
What's it called? Pronunciation. Is that the word you're saying?
Yeah.
Abhorrent. Abhorrent.
I'm hearing abhorrent.
Abhorrent.
Mm-hmm. Abhorrent. Abhorrent.
Yeah, abhorrent.
Abhorrent.
Yeah, we're saying.
Deserving strong dislike or hatred. Use it again in a sentence.
You okay, Randy?
Did you fall? Causing repugnance.
Oh, yeah. Love the word repugnant. Oh.
Oh.
We just got our food. Randy's going to be trying. Oh, that's great.
Randy's trifling.
That hit the deck. Saying, oh, it is a twist off. And I got you a Mexican Coke.
Oh, thank you.
I got you a Mexican Coke,
cream.
Randy.
Sea cream.
Oh, God, I hope they have all of our stuff on the side. I'm going to be freaking pissed if they don't. Oh.
What?
I just straight up go, I'm going to be pissed if they don't. No fucking lid was on.
That would be abhorrent.
Abhorrent.
And one more time in a sentence.
You, abhorrent. Those crimes are abhorrent.
They're abhorrent.
Ooh, need to drop down a little bit. I'm having some back issues lately.
Me too.
Well, while we're doing...
Oh, that's a little too low.
Is it? Because I'm actually feeling good.
Well, you know me. It's hard for me to get up.
Oh, for sure.
Because I'm elder. Thanks, brother.
I get what you're saying. It's not at a nice standing.
It's got my name on it.
Yeah, I put our names in there.
Yeah.
Right
yeah.
here, Thanks. Right now. I'm going to be drinking today a certified organic black tea. It's a Sri Lankan black tea, slightly sweetened, hint of lemon. Mm-hmm. That's what I've got going on. So it's slightly sweetened.
Thanks, Randy. I can't believe they put my name on it.
Yes, I asked for that on the side. God, I was about to be fucking pissed if it wasn't on there.
Mm.
Right here, right now. This is great. So to let everybody know what we ordered, I'm going to go through. Might as well, while we're eating. I'm a big Chipotle fan. Like to shake my bowl, and I am going to be shaking it here in a moment.
Did I get the queso for my chips and my side?
Did you get a side of queso?
I should have. Two.
Yeah, there should have been two sides of queso. Is there not? Did you not get queso?
No, you got chips too.
No, I did. I did, but they did not.
Then you eat these. No.
Did,
yes. Did you get queso
Randy,
cheese?
This is the whole reason you wanted it. Take it.
Take it. Yeah. These motherfuckers. My fucking guacamole isn't in here. I'm not calling them back. I swear. Come on, motherfuckers. You fucking serious, Clark?
Clark. Oh, good.
Oh, God. I'm so fucking mad about my guacamole. Is
Randy.
It on there? I didn't add my guacamole on this. No, I literally didn't add it.
Randy,
so it's my
get
fault.
It. Take it, Randy.
The only person I can be mad at right now is myself. Mm-hmm. And that's the only person. It's no one else's fault except mine.
Randy put this on my pocketbook.
That's a hard pill to swallow. That is a hard pill to swallow when, at a time when you don't have anybody to blame but yourself. Because I've had to do that before.
Well, who do we have to blame for my queso and cheese not getting here? Randy, yeah. You take this. Boy.
You have half and I'll have half. Fair enough.
All right. I mean, this is my half right here.
Okay. Again, nobody to blame but me. I only ordered one chips and queso.
Well.
Very sorry about that, guys. Nobody to blame but me. But did not order guacamole either. So, again, nobody to blame but me. I am sorry, because that's actually soured the experience for me right now. And I'm trying to be positive, because that's been my MO lately, trying to be positive. Just trying to feel good, do good, cool things. Been watching Succession, and boy, there ain't nothing like watching a show about a lot of fucking wealthy motherfuckers to make you be like, boy, I'm not such a bad egg, am I? It's a show on HBO about a, like, mogul family.
Whoa.
That owns the, like, biggest media news company or whatever. What's that called? What's a cool name for it? God, I wanted to say it and sound cool. I'm owning that. I wanted to say it so I sounded cool and, like, I knew what I was talking about. It's a media giant.
Mogul?
Corporate. Mogul. Corporate mogul, news mogul. What the fuck's that called?
Mogul?
It's not. No, it's not. It's not mogul, the word I've said 15 times.
Mogul?
Let me look up the log line of Succession so I can just hit you with it.
I'm going to have one more, Randy, and then I'm done.
I can't Google Succession because I haven't watched the end of it yet. Basically, very, very wealthy family that owns the largest media company, what one would say is globally. I'm assuming they're kind of modeling it after like Rupert Murdoch, who has Fox News. Media conglomerate. I got to it.
Love the word conglomerate.
Me too. And I didn't have to Google it. I'm so proud of myself. Trying to use my brain for things when I need them. I sound like Brett right now, but I truly do mean that. But I'm not as ate up as Brett is.
Birds aren't real. Yeah.
Some would say I am as ate up as Brett is.
Mother of God.
I've been dying for an excuse to get down there.
Oh, between my legs?
To eat your little pink pussy.
A little tight little pink pussy.
Thanks,
Randy. Yeah, no problem.
I fucking love when you do that laugh.
So stupid.
I will say, when I got here and I was like, oh my God, I need my charger. It did feel very much like we were on the road because you were like, okay, I got one. Libby always had to be the charger person for us. Every now and then I would kill it, but.
I was just the mom.
Yeah.
I was the mom of the tour.
How have you been dealing with being off the road?
Loving it.
Me too. It's definitely taken me some adjusting. I mean.
I was really taking a toll on me.
Oh,
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Well, because you flew straight from home to Denver, right?
Sure did. Had the best time ever.
What'd y'all do? Why are you laughing?
I'm laughing because we started a new YouTube series.
Oh, yeah, the hotel thing.
Called Checking In.
Cool.
It was a swingers hotel.
Yes. Did you guys fuck other people?
Well, light swinging.
What's light swinging mean?
Not like a full
switch.
You
just walk over to their light switch and you go, woo-hoo. And by their light switch, I mean their cock.
It was wild.
Wait a sec. Are you not going to tell me about all this?
Yeah. I'm eating. I can't tell you all in one sentence.
For sure. This is gonna be a. I feel like we still have so much to talk about and cover, which is great. Cause golly, we gotta record three.
We got a lot of episodes to record.
We gotta record three episodes in the next few days.
I don't want to spoil too much because I still have another part of the episode to put out.
Well, why don't we do that? Oh, that's actually great. If you guys are down, we could finish this and then do another one.
Mm-hmm.
And are you guys okay with that?
Yeah.
Well, I think that's great. So let me finish talking about in this episode that I'll finish talking about succession and weird stuff like that. I don't know what I was talking about, but.
Moguls.
Ooh. Yeah.
Conglomerate.
I am a mogul. But basically the show is like this fucking billionaire family. Massive, owns a massive media conglomerate. That's how I want to say conglomerate every time. Conglomerate.
Mm-hmm.
Like it's like a wrestling move, you know? Hi. And you walk out dressed like a businessman. That's a good fucking wrestling guy's idea.
Would he walks out. Good guy or bad guy?
Bad guy for sure.
For sure.
Because he starts out good. You think he's, would that be considered a heel?
That'd
or it's kind
heel.
Of sometimes good, sometimes bad?
A heel's bad.
Oh, a heel's bad always?
Mm-hmm. Think so.
You should look at the bottom of my heel.
Holy shit.
Because it is not good.
I just want to apologize for eating. I'm just so hungry.
Do you know what I realize is when we eat on the podcast? In a mukbang, you're not eating as much. Sometimes you are eating for strength. And I think that it shows. You know, if you're doing a mukbang and someone's just like gobbling down like I did in me and Beth and Maggie's mukbang, which, by the way, I do want to, we'll get into this in the next episode. There's not necessarily drama, but I have some grievances.
With who?
About things. Not any of our friends at all. Just women, just the way that media and the way that fucking everyone is like portrayed, like thinking they should talk to about women monitoring their fucking bodies. This saying people are crackheads. People were... So many people were calling me like a fucking spaz and a crackhead on Maggie and Beth's mukbang, which, to be honest, I was very, very fidgety there. But it's like I was in the very back seat and I was so physically uncomfortable because that medication that I was on that I had to stop taking that was like making me constantly flushed.
Mm-hmm.
It was like making me sweat so badly 24/7 that... It's like I would just be anxious and be like, oh, my God, I'm like fucking drenched in sweat. I'd be always messing with my hair, doing whatever. So it made me hella insecure. And I was like, I definitely got to get off this medicine because I look like a straight motherfucking tweaker. But it's not that the medicine's not even helping me with my fucking ADD. It was helping me to sweat, to make me look like I just got sober yesterday. I'm fucking... Tussle my hair 78 times. I like watched some of that footage and I was like, ugh. I go, well, I do look pretty sweaty.
I haven't watched it.
It doesn't matter. It's not, that's not even the point. I'm just like talking about like, you know, negative shit like that. And then I got the shittiest comment. I'm not even going to tell you who told me this at work. This is the gossip corner, guys. We're gossiping. I'm gossiping about shit that's going on with me lately.
Uh-huh.
So, I'm at work. I've been back at work for two weeks now. Came back like the 23rd or something like that. Been back at work for a few weeks. And I am putting like cups away. I was like the manager or whatever at work. And this person, I'm
like
not gonna,
ramekins.
Yeah, I was putting away ramekins, cups, all sorts of stuff. But I was bent down grabbing cups from this person and putting them into the thing. And I'm not going to say who it was because I don't want everyone to hate him because this person doesn't really have a filter and they just whatever. It's fucking open your mouth. Let's go. I'm going to tell you what he said to me, this motherfucker. I'm so mad at him, but also it's like funny, but I'm also mad and sad. This person at work, I'm bent down the other day. He's like, hey, Tina, we've all been talking and you look a lot different. You're a lot heavier than when you, oh my God, I almost fucking, and he's like, we've all been talking back here. And we've all been talking verbatim said, we've all been talking and you know, you look different. You're a lot heavier. And you know, I just looked at him because I was like so fucking mad, but I was also like, what are you doing? You can't say this to people.
What the fuck?
And so I turned around and as he's like, oh, you know, you look different. I just look at him. I go, oh, cool. Got it. Awesome. That's great. And he's like, yeah, you know, a lot heavier, but, you know, he's still got a pretty face. And I was like, what the fuck?
God.
Oh, man, I almost fell out. And then he, like, this person doubles down even more. On that, they're like 20 minutes. He was like, you know, you must have been eating good, you know? And I was like, I actually was eating very good. I had a lot of king crab, a lot of really great things while I was on the road, you motherfucker. And you didn't try that fucking king crab. I tried, you know, I was like getting mad. And then later, I'm sitting at a table doing the schedule, working on stuff. And there's all these girls around me sitting. We're catching up. I'd only been back like a week or a week and a half or something. And everyone's got food in front of them. And this person at work walks out and was like, oh, you're eating good. Tina's eating good. And I lost it. I was like, this is not my fucking food. I'm like, this is their food. Also, mind your own fucking business. I'm like, you don't need to be worried about what I'm eating, what I'm doing, where I've fucking been. Leave me the fuck alone. And then they were like, and just kind of walked away. I'm like, bro, you are out of control. The same person. Open your mouth. Let's go.
Does he think that he was complimenting you?
I have no idea. But what I do know is that for a moment, I was really, really angry because I was angry for multiple reasons because my body has changed to what it was a year, 2 years ago, whatever. It has changed. And I have not necessarily even thought that that's a bad thing or whatever. It's just a different thing. And I struggled with an eating disorder for so much of my life and like weird shit like that. So it's like my whole life I was like, I'm so scared. In the back of my mind, I was like, oh, my God, I was terrified to like be fat. Mm-hmm. I was literally just terrified. And then, you know, and I've said that before, like it's like it happened and I start whatever, you know, it's like I gained weight and I was like, oh, I'm good. Everything's good. I still have all this, you know, whatever. And it's like all these things I built up in my head forever. Had nothing to do with, you know, it's like it came true, this big fear that I had, that I thought everything was going to, I was going to lose control and then nothing happened. So my point in saying all that is like in the last couple few months, I've started to feel shitty, physically, whatever, you know, just not fitting into my clothes, feeling hot because of that medication, feeling very just gross. Just all around, not even necessarily correlated to what I look like physically. Just kind of feeling grody, you know, like I'm like, damn, I just need to be drinking more water and eating more veggies, not eating fucking beef jerky or whatever processed bullshit we're eating every day.
Right.
Hope someone saw that little food that spit out. Did you see that?
I didn't
see it. You know, I was a bit uncomfortable with my body when I started to gain more weight. And I was like, it was different. I was like, whoa, this is weird. You know, this has never happened, whatever. And I'm like, oh, all these things are great. My self-worth is not correlated with my weight and yada, yada, yada. And then I started to gain more and more weight, you know, which is fine. But I started to kind of feel physically uncomfortable with the clothing I had, with the certain medication, all that. There was a lot of different factors. And I started to feel like, God, I'm just not feeling good. I'm not feeling it, whatever. And you always think that that's like a thing that you are like going on the inside. But it was like to have this person who I know didn't mean any harm. I really don't. This person, you know, doesn't, they've definitely got some social norms that they don't understand, you know, which is fine, whatever. But it was like, it weirdly validated in my head. I'm like, oh, so all of this shit I've been feeling on the inside the last few months, if kind of feeling gross and blah, 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 and just like, bleh, is valid, is like confirmed by someone now. Do you know what I mean? That's what it felt like to me. And I know when I write those things down on paper and I look at all of those things together, it's not actually this person said something shitty to me. And the part that makes me the most uncomfortable about it is like, why are y'all monitoring my body?
And why and are my they back weight? There talking about it?
Oh, God, I was pissed.
Why are they back there in a group talking about it? That's not appropriate for work or anywhere.
No. But my point is all these motherfuckers, dude, and it's always fucking dudes. I mean, I don't know. And I guess it's everyone. It's everyone in the world. They all fucking just, we have all this shit we think we're supposed to be saying and doing and fucking talking about people's fucking weight like that and like deciding like, that's a bad thing, you know, like coming up to me and commenting on that. And I guess like these people have commented in the past if I've like lost weight or whatever and all. It's just, it was all around just not fun. And that happened the other day. And I was just like, I was mad, but also laughing because it's like, I can, even though it hurt my feelings that this person said that they'd all been talking about me, because that was the part that I really didn't like.
That is disgusting.
I'm like, bitch, I don't care if you notice that these fat ass titties be moving a little quicker, you know? I don't care about that. They be, no, and what I mean by quicker is slower, because they got a little more hump to it. Either way, it's just, it grossed me out. It made me feel really, really, really just all around. I was like, don't worry about what I'm fucking doing. I don't mind your, everyone needs to mind their own fucking
business.
Even
if it wasn't like a weight thing, even if you said like, oh, we've all been talking about some other thing. It's like, ew, why?
We've all been talking about your fat ass or something fucking.
Your
I'd be
big
like,
pussy.
Ew. They're like, we've all been talking about, we've all been talking about that, you know, little labia that you got. Yeah. It was
horrifying.
It was just like, ugh, yuck. I mean, so.
And then we're sitting here eating while we're talking about it.
I know, right?
That's the best part. I'm chowing down. I'm like,
oh, I hope that a motherfucker does say something about it. Do it. I don't give a fuck.
We have to eat.
You got to eat.
You got to eat.
You got to eat. And guess what? You're getting a raw and uncut. Randy, what do you think about Chipotle? Give us your lowdown right now.
I like it. It was very good, man. The spicy sauce was very spicy. I like that very much. I love spicy food. Yeah, very good. I like it. I like the chicken al pastore.
Dude.
Whatever the fuck it's called.
That salsa hits, motherfucker.
That corn salsa hits.
This would blast you
love
into
it.
Space, dude. This red tomatillo salsa. I know for a fact you'd be like,
no, thank you.
You would start sweating like I do on that medication.
I wouldn't sweat. I'd pass away.
Was it the medication we were talking about off the air before that I was on also?
Strattera?
No, Lexapro.
No, I'm on Lexapro and been on Lexapro forever. Love Lexapro.
Big Lexapro fan.
Unless you don't want to come.
I think it's worse for some people than others. We want to come.
We want to come.
But yeah, so... I'm not saying that story to make anyone feel weird or feel weird about their bodies, whether your body's the same as it always has been, different than it was a year ago, whatever. I'm more saying it to just be like, you know, I started to be like, oh, everyone's like talking about it. I started to get very down on myself and feel very shitty. And I'm like, oh, what do you know? It's like, just cool. Another thing, like, oh, being fat is disgusting. We're all talking about you.
Mm-hmm.
And I was just like, God, y'all, I was just like, y'all suck. I'm like, you know how many fucking times I see your crusty ass fucking ass cracks while you're about to fucking put something in the fryer and your fucking dirty undies and your nasty ass fucking shirts and I don't fucking say shit. I see all your fucking little beer bellies that are a weird, almost dismembered size because it's all beer related. And I don't fucking care.
I see your little ding dongs.
Why the fuck do you care? Come here. Let me just look at the outline. I'll tell you how big that dick gets hard. What if I could do that?
Let me just suck it here real quick. Oh, suck on it.
If you could lodge that right here. You could just park it, kind of like
tongue in cheek.
Nicotine gum. You chew it and you park it. You park it. Why don't you park that little dinger right here, and I'll let you know what's
dinger.
All right, hell yeah. Well, I think that's enough for today.
Glad to be back.
Glad to be back.
Glad to be back, that's for sure.
And that's for sure. And then, yeah, I say we do one more. 7:50, hell yeah.
Hell, we could do five more.
No, we can't. I don't have the mental energy. I love y'all.
Love ya. And cut.
Wait, what was that sound? Was that the end of the crystal farm?
That's the beginning, wasn't it?
It was the beginning of a different one. I hit the wrong button. I was not prepared. I was stuffing my fucking face.
That's hilarious, because all I heard was a little...
I heard the... Oh, no.
Yeah, and the one her friend... I think she was making her friend film her farting, and her friend had done a few of them. Was like, oh, no. Like, not again.
Nah. The last.
Dude, that's fucking great.